Good morning, I'm Hope Sabara, and this session is kind of dedicated towards back hair. And it'll be a little bit of maybe some untraditional back hair, maybe what you're not used to. We'll be doing both dynamic movement and some holding postures, and really playing with the muscles of the lower back and the hips. In particular, as we age, we have a muscle in the lower back called the quadratus liberum. It's more of a rectangular or square-like muscle, and it comes up to the top of the sacrum and attaches to the bottom of the rib. There's one on each side. And as we age, the muscle tends to get stiffer and to be a lot of a culprit for back pain. Particularly for people that have more of a sedentary lifestyle, this guy tends to get very stiff. And unfortunately, the quadratus liberum is a muscle that doesn't have a whole lot of elasticity. So once he gets stiff, he really stays stiff. So to be able to break that up feels really good. And in the lower back, we also have other muscles. We have the psoas coming through the groin and belly to attach to every vertebrae from T12 down and also to the bottom of the rib cage. We also have latissimus dorsi coming up the lower back and actually attaching on the inside of the humerus, as well as the trapezius coming down and attaching down in the lower thoracic region. So we have all of these intercepting muscles that definitely play into back hair. So we'll try to play dynamically with different movements and functionally to be able to leave you feeling great today. Let's begin. Start seated cross-legged. And if you need to, feel free, you can bring yourself onto a blanket or a cushion. You just don't want to feel like your knees end up as elbow rests. Really allow the belly to be exposed and the spine to feel nice and tall. The hands will be used as leverage points on the knees. As you exhale, press away with the left hand as you circle to the right, down to the floor, and then press to the right knee as you circle up. And if you'd like to, I'm gonna encourage you to close the eyes to really feel some great rhythm. Inhale when you upswing, and exhale when you downswing. Allow the shoulders to get into the movement, allow the head to drop, and circle slightly back beyond neutral. Allow your sit bones to play a little bit. Exhale and inhale. Nice. Try not to overthink the movement. And notice your torso not just going up and down, but rotating into the twist. If you watch my torso, I'm actually rotating my right down as I move to the left. And I'm rotating my left side of my body down as I rotate to the right. So kind of making it like this dance. About four more. And just a little pressure to open up the side body. No tension in the neck. One more. And when you peek to the top on this last one, just reverse and go the opposite way. So exhale in the downswing, inhaling up. Maybe smile a little bit. Our lower backs hold a lot of fear and tension, so allowing that fear and tension to dissolve. Working on stimulating the kidneys today. Keep breathing. Try not to be afraid of the rhythm in your own body. Keep breathing. About four more. You're doing great. Three. And two. No neck tension. Last one. And great job. Come back upright. Inhale, arms come out to T. Relax your shoulders. Let's just do two chest openers. Inhale, heart moves forward. Shoulders move back. Gently look up. Exhale, round the back. Chin to chest, little hug. Inhale, open. And exhale, little hug. How about one more? Inhale. And I'm alternating my arms crossing. Exhale. Inhale, end in a hug manner. And exhale, lower the arms down. Come to kneeling. So we'll end up sitting on the heels of the feet. So if you feel like sitting on your ankles is too much pressure or tension, stick a block between the thighs and you can sit on the block. You can also roll up a cushion or a blanket and sit on that as well. So know that you have that play. We won't be sitting sedentary. We'll actually be moving our hips and heels a little bit. I'm gonna turn backwards so you can see what I'm talking about. As I side bend to what would be my left, my hips are going to shift to the right. So as I reach, I'm really opening the hip as I lengthen to the left side. And then inhale, coming through center, and exhaling, doing the same thing the opposite way. Remembering that tightness travels. So if we just move in the upper body and never let our lower body move, all we're doing is playing with the spine. I want you to actually play with the hips. And remember, the spine goes all the way down to the tailbone. We often think about the spine stopping just at the lower back, and really it continues even beyond that. All right, so let's begin. Arms open to T, relax your shoulders, no force. Bottom shoulder stays relaxed. We're gonna move to the right. Right hand drops down, inhale, reach. And then through center, exhale, inhale. Notice how my top palm is turning down rather than up. Inhale, as you reach. And exhale, inhale, and exhale. If it's more comfortable, feel free to look down. And if you need to, just bring the hand to the side of the head as you curl, if you feel like the arm creates too much length for your body. And length meaning like it might be a little too tense still. Inhale when you stretch, and exhaling. Inhale, lengthen, and exhale. Really focus from the stretch. Coming from the hip. Remember, all the muscles in the torso feed down into the hips. Even if it's not the exact muscle, it turns into another muscle and eventually feeds into the pelvis. Inhale, come through center, and exhale, side bend. Inhale, come through center. Nice. So if you find that you prefer to exhale when you side bend, if that's what you're used to, go for it. I just want you breathing. But ideally, the inhale, and then extending is gonna be that reach. Good. Let's go four more each way. Really focus on the hip pressing rather than trying to get all the way to the floor. Relax the bottom shoulder. Great job. Keep breathing. Reach and center. Reach and center. Breathe. Each time feels a little bit better. Last set. Inhale, reach, and exhale, center. Inhale, reach, and exhale, center. Two heart opening breaths. Inhale, arms come back. Heart moves forward. Exhale, round the spine. Hug your heart. Inhale, open the arms. Hug the arm on opposite on top. Now exhale. Inhale, open. Last one. Exhale, opposite on top. And then inhale, come up right. Let's take a moment, roll the shoulders, make sure there's no tension carried with. Great, let's come on to our backs. So lay onto your back. And as you lay onto your back, if you need to, have a head support, especially for my viewers today that have a really excessive maybe chin lift, and that may be due to tight shoulders or tight pectorals. So feel free, get something under your head so your head lays more neutral in line with the neck. And that will also help with core strength. So when the head and the shoulders are grabbing, it becomes really difficult to allow the core to turn on. All right, a few rounds of pelvic tilting. On the inhalation, allow the low back to arch away. Think about tipping your hips. Your hip bones are gonna go up towards the sky. Your pubis bone turns down towards the floor. And then exhale without squeezing your glutes. Low back drops into the mat. Pelvic floor sinks inward, belly hollows towards the floor. My feet are pressing slightly into the mat. Inhale, arch. Lots of play. Notice how my upper body gets involved. And then exhaling, dropping, relax the rib cage. Good. Inhale, let's get the arms involved now. And exhale. Great. Inhale, and I'm just going to move my blocks here. And exhale. One more time. Inhale. And if your arms don't touch the floor, don't force them. Just allow your body to go where it goes. And then exhaling, dropping into the floor. Inhale, come into neutral. Neutral means that your pubis bone and your hip bones are parallel with the sky. Make sure that your upper back feels long. It doesn't feel stuck or pulled into a position it doesn't belong. So that when you exhale, your rib cage just gently relaxes down. Now, for those of us with more of a protruding rib cage, this is a work in progress. Just really use your breath on the exhalation to relax the rib cage from any tension.
Arms will open to T, palms face up. Why I'm going to encourage you to go palms face up is that when we turn the palms down, what do you think we're going to try to start using instead of our core? Our arm strength. So by turning the palms up, we again mentally and physically shift the load into the core where it belongs. All right, keeping our pelvis in neutral, inhale, lift the legs to a tabletop, flex the feet, and glue the legs together. Pelvic floor is engaging and inner belly is engaging. Now, remembering ideally, eventually the pelvic floor should automatically turn on, meaning I don't have to tell myself, pelvic floor, turn on. It's much like your bicep. You don't tell your bicep to pick up a box off the floor or bicep contract as you pick the milk jug up off the countertop. Our pelvic floor ideally should work in that same manner, but for many of us, it's kind of a recouping process, and we have to remind our proprioceptors in that area of the body what they're supposed to be doing as they talk to our brain. All right, so on the inhalation, keep the legs together, flex the feet. I want you to tip your hips halfway to the left. So I'm about 45 degrees. On the exhalation, like you're drawing a horizontal line from your oblique to your belly button, exhale, contract, and draw yourself to center. Opposite side, inhale. And then exhale, the exhale takes you back to center. Inhale, tip, relax your shoulders, and exhale, come back to center. You're rolling right across the sacrum, so it's a nice release for the lower back. Exhale, back to center. Notice if you're using your hip flexors, okay? I want you to pay attention that you're not using your hip flexors. Inhale when you twist, and then exhaling again, contract, come back to center. Inhaling when you twist, and exhaling, contract, come back to center. Inhale when you twist. Notice if your shoulders are jerking up off the mat, don't go as far. Now we're gonna add the legs into the movement. Let's just bring the knees into the chest here for a little break. Spread open the lower back, and then drop the feet to the floor again. Readjust the pelvis into neutral again. So as you find pelvic neutral, again, pelvic floor contracts, legs lift, arms open to T. Same movement, except we're going to add a leg extension. Inhale, tip the hips to the left. Exhale, extend the heels, belly is super strong, obliques working. Inhale, back to about 45. Exhale, back to center. So each movement is a half breath. Inhale, exhale, breathe out, inhale, and exhale, contract. Nice, inhale, and exhale, inhale, and exhale, back to center. Inhale, tip, you're doing great. Exhale, extend, inhale, bend, and exhale, back to center. Now you know the breath, keep going. And as you work with this movement, I really want you to pay attention to other areas of the body acting up to try to compensate. It's not so much the movement that's going to give us the results that we want, but what's happening in the movement. And that's what makes such a difference between mindful movement and just movement. Extend out, exhale, inhale, bend. Remember, exhale like a rope is dragging you back to center. Think inside your belly, there's little hands pulling you back like a fishing reel. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Now I know the temptation, inhaling tip, is to go all the way down to the floor thinking more is better. I want you to pay attention to the quality of the movement. Also, if you have tighter hips, hamstrings or hips, you might find that their extension is only half, okay? You're not gonna go fully extended. And then back to center, exhale. Last two sets, so inhale, exhale, extend, inhale, exhale, bend, inhale, exhale, extend. Also that QL muscle, if that guy's tighter, it's not gonna let you rotate as far. Last set, inhale, exhale, extend. Keep the inner belly transversus strong so your hip flexors don't do all the work. Last one, inhale, shoulders are soft, exhale, extend, inhale, bend, and exhale, back to center. One hand on each knee, individual circles on the lower back. See if your arm can move your leg rather than your leg moving itself so that you can really soften the hips and the hip joints. So a few times each direction. And then a nice hug into the chest. Exhale, flex the feet. On the exhalation again now, contract the belly, nose to knees, thighs compress the abdomen, allow your lengthening your sacrum and tailbone. Inhale, head drops back, Exhale, feet drop to the floor. Turn off to the side. Use your top hand for support so your head doesn't do all the lifting.
Come into a tabletop position. Awesome. Hands and knees. Fingertips nice and wide. Fold to the elbows. Turn in line with the middle finger. Why is this important? Because when the fold to the elbows turn in, what muscles do you think you're going to overuse? Your chest muscles. And for many of us, this is such a dominant area of the body, and we've done a lot of excessive use here and here, that we avoid this part of the body. It's like having a kitchen table, and it's 8 or 10 feet long, and then you never put a second set of legs in the middle. Your core is the second set of legs in the middle, okay? So it's a big distance between your pelvis and your shoulder girdle. We need to activate what's in the middle, whether it be a stretch or a strengthen. All right, so hands and knees, tabletop position. And extend now what would be your right leg out, ball of the foot on the floor. Let's just press through the heel, a little bit of a calf release. Keep the quadriceps strong and press through the arms. Couple good breaths. And then release that calf stretch. Inhale, bring the left arm out to T, and then thread the needle as you drop onto the shoulder. So using the leg actually to help straighten out the spine a little bit. For those of us with tighter spines, we bend both knees and our hips come flying towards our face. Our back looks like a C rather than in a nice neutral line, which is definitely gonna affect the discs and the vertebrae. So inhale, press your torso open using the face arm. And now let's press through the back heel as much as we can so you can draw the right hip away from your face. That's the hip of the extended leg. Inhale, press open. And exhale, you may feel more tension through the spine, not just in the lower back, but between the shoulder blades as well. Let's try a little balance pose. Inhale, extend the base arm up to the sky. Press your bottom arm into the floor. Now, eye line is either up or straight forward at the mat. Inhale now, lift your extended leg off the floor. Let's take 5 breaths. Three more breaths. Last breath. Exhale, lower the leg down, hand to the floor. Inhale, unwind. Let's take now the base arm. Keep it planted, but take your floating arm and open up. Press your extended thigh to the sky. Open and breathe. Look up if you can. Exhale, lower down. Hands and knees, tabletop. I'm going to turn around so I'm going to face you, but you can just do the opposite side. Fold to the elbows forward. Left leg extends back. Reach through the heel of the foot, keeping the quadricep firm. Belly is supporting. Nice calf release here. Remember, the more restricted we are in the legs and feet, the more dysfunctional our core is. So really important to focus on your lower body. All right, release from the calf stretch. Inhale, extend your right arm out like an airplane wing. Exhale, just thread it through. Try to slide the arm as far as you can go comfortably. Use your base arm and inhale, press open. Almost like you're gonna fall back gently, but obviously try not to fall over. Inhale and exhale. I'm utilizing my breath in order to enhance the pose. So when I inhale, I'm gonna try to press my torso open. And as I exhale, I'm gonna feel the benefits of that space. Relax any tension from the bottom shoulder itself and just reach through the back heel. Create some strength in the extended leg. All right, let's take this to a balance challenge. Inhale, arm extends up, broken table, and exhale, slowly lift the leg. Let's hold and breathe. Three more breaths, smile. Exhale, lower the leg and lower the top arm down. Now remember, inhale, bring the arm out like an airplane wing. Keep your extended thigh strong and press open, rotating in the spine. Now you may feel some groin work. Inhale through the nose. If it's not comfortable to look up, then look down, but create some sort of neck rotation. Two more breaths. Last breath. And exhale, lower the arms and legs down. Great job. Turn to a kneeling position. So hands and knees, nice little bit of core strength. Inhale, now balance over on the right leg and extend the left leg out to the side. I like to use the front edge of my mat so I know that my body's in a nice long line. Open the pelvis and groin. Inhale, arms open to T, relax the shoulders, let's move to the left. So as you drop the left arm down, relax the shoulder, extend the top arm up, exposing the inner groin. Remember, we have muscles running through our inner hip flexor and coming into our lower back. So exposing the groin is gonna help release that lower back. And exhale, side bend. And if you'd like to, take your bottom hand and lengthen your top wrist. Inhale through the nose. Exhale, close down towards the leg. Inhale, open. And exhale, reaching, close down towards the leg. Shoulders stay relaxed. Inhale, open. Exhale, close down towards the leg. Inhale, open. Exhale, close down towards the leg. Last one. Inhale, open. No tension in the neck. Exhale, reach as you close down towards the leg. Inhale, roll up. Arms come to T. Balance, bring the leg in. And down. Let's try the opposite side. Inhale and exhale. Get a little bit of some footwork. So as I press the outer edge of my foot down, I'm working through my inner ankle and outer ankle. Open and expose the pelvis. Arms float up. Exhale, reach over to the right and extend your left arm over. Not just the palm is going to turn down, but the whole bicep's going to rotate in. So I'm maximizing the openness of my upper back. Bottom hand comes up. I'm going to latch onto the wrist, a little bit of an extension. Exhale as I close. And inhale as I open. I'm going to try to turn my heart up. Exhale as I close. And inhale as I open. You may feel a lot of internal and external oblique work down the side body all the way into the rib cage. Inhale as I open. Exhale, lengthen. Really reach past the foot. Inhale as you open. Exhale as you close. It's the last one. Inhale as you open. And exhale as you close. Roll yourself up. Arms open to T and bring the leg in. We're going to do the 2-to-1 ratio. So which side felt more restricted? Whichever side felt more restricted, that's the side I want you to go back to and stretch. So I'm going to be working with my left side. Arms open, extend. My right foot might be your left foot. And then as the arms open, let yourself reach over towards the straight leg. Top arm comes over, grab for the wrist gently. As I lengthen the arm, I'm keeping the shoulders soft. 5 times. Exhale as I close, and inhale as I open. Exhale, breathe, and inhale. Now it's okay if your spine rounds a little bit. We're trying to expose the vertebrae and expose any sort of tension, not only through the lower back, but through the rib cage. Exhale, and inhale. Let's go 2 more. Exhale, and inhale. Last one, exhale, stay here. Inhale, roll up. And exhale, bring the leg in. Awesome job, arms drop down. Come to standing. Let's move through standing forward bend. Feet come to the floor, relax your head, give it a good shake. Deep inhalation, little bend in the knees if you need to. Exhale. Inhale, roll yourself up. Hip bones move forward as you bend back, so there's no low back pain. Exhale, hands to namaste. Great, warrior two. So we're gonna take a spin on warrior two. It's what I call functional folded warrior two. Left toes turn out. Right toes turn in. Now I'm heel to heel, center arch, ball of the foot. It's not a blueprint exact. So we tend to hear so much rigidity and how our body should be aligned in yoga in areas that there really shouldn't be rigidity. So what I mean by that is depending on how open your hips are will depend on where the heel, front heel, lines up with the back foot. No knee pain, bend the front knee, and you may need to maximize your stride if your front knee is coming way over the ankle.
Try to keep the back leg strong and work to keep the front knee bent so we can really work with this great rotation in the front hip joint that will have a really positive effect on working the lower back. Now, transversus is resisting gravity as we fold. Pelvic floor is strong. Watch not to flare the body out. Where all this work we just did on the lower back is now shortened and tightening, I want you to keep it open and lengthening. Great. All right, arms open to T. Let's find Virutu. Exhale, drop into the front knee. Keep the thighs nice and strong. Exhale as you fold. Let your hips push back as you fold forward. And then inhale, come up. Now either stay here or we're going to go into a functional back bend. I very gently want you to lead with the hips as you lean back. It's not going to be big. Exhale and inhale. No gripping toes. Exhale and inhale. Exhale, a lot of work with the deep rotators of the hips, an area that we often don't access unless we're really focusing on it. Exhale and inhale. Four more. Exhale. Lengthen through the crown of the head. Let your hips push back, almost like you're looking for a little chair to sit on behind you. Two more. Last one. Now stay here, drop your right hand to the floor, or feel free to grab a block, especially if you're tighter or limited in rotation. Fold of the elbow turns towards me and turn now into twisted folded warrior. Press out of the bottom arm and rotate. Now the stronger you keep your back thigh muscle, the more you're going to feel like you have support rather than strain. Breathe. Nice rotation on the neck. Bring the chin in towards the shoulder. Inhale, top arm comes down halfway. Exhale, bottom arm comes up halfway. Inhale, up into that extension. Exhale, hands to prayer. Nice job. Straighten the front leg, spread the opposite side. Rotate the back toes in. And what was your back foot? Now it's going to be your front. Level out the pelvis. Exhale, bend your front knee. All right, keeping your identity center to yourself. That inner transversus muscle is ready and strong. Arms open to T, 10 folds. Exhale, and inhale. Exhale, and inhale. Exhale. Now, the more restricted our pelvis is when we back bend, we may have a tendency to want to just use the upper body. I really want you to focus on the hips moving. Exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Rise. Four more. Move with your breath. Three more. Doing great. Last one. We'll rise up. Come into that fold. Drop now your left hand to the block if you need to. Fold the elbow towards me and rotate towards your Warrior II front leg. Pressing out of the shoulder. Work to rotate. Not just in one area of the spine, but get the whole spine twisting. Thighs are strong. Breath is open and enjoy the ride. Take the top arm, exhale down, inhale, hold here, exhale, and now rise up, inhale, a little back bend, and hands to prayer. Straighten the front leg, and walk the feet together. Great job. Come into chair pose. I'm going to turn sideways here, so I'm going to kind of be moving different directions so you can see my body, so feel free, you can just face me. Spread the toes nice and wide, and bring your feet comfortably together. If you're more comfortable with your feet wider, men in particular usually are, stick a block or a small mini ball
between the thighs to keep the legs planted. I'm actually going to use the block. It really can help activate the pelvic floor. The inner thighs are the pelvic floor's favorite neighbor. So when those guys start to activate, it does stimulate that trampoline, which is the superficial pelvic floor.
All right, feet will mimic the space of the block. And now let's sit back. So hips hinge, torso leans forward. You might need to readjust again. Hands come to the knees. Now we'll be in chair pose doing cat-cow. Inhale, press your hips back. Not just your tailbone, but get your sit bones moving in your pants. Move your heart forward and up. Shoulders drop down. Exhale, round the spine. Shoulders come forward, tailbone tucks, belly hollows. Inhale. And exhale, pelvic floor rises, stepping some core work. Inhale, notice if you want to ride to the outer edges of the feet. Try to keep your feet planted. Inhale. Exhale, are your sit bones sticky in your muscle or do they actually move? Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. I'm going to turn towards you for the last three. Inhale. Exhale through your whole spine. Stretch like putty, not just front and back, but up and down as well. And exhale. Last one, inhale. And exhale. Rise to standing. Now functional back bend. Pelvis leads forward. As you lean back, you're gonna feel your whole trunk turn on. Exhale, hands to prayer. Great job, release the block. As you release your block off to the side, just step to the top of the mat comfortably. We'll work our way down. Inhale, arms come up. And exhale, swan dive. Bend your knees. Inhale, look forward. Step, jump, or walk back, your choice. Plank position, downward dog, exhale. Fingertips are nice and wide. Try to get out of the habit of sinking your chest and really wrenching your shoulders. Stay lifted through that deep transversus muscle and let your hips be pulled back. Folds of the elbows turn forward, keeping your thumb and pointer fingers still anchored. All right, I call this twisted dog. It's almost like you're on discs on your feet. If feet will turn to your right as your hips sink to the left, press through the arms. You're feeling lots of stretch on the side of your body. Your knees are turning towards. Inhale, come to center. Keep your head relaxed. And exhale, turn your hips and feet. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale and exhale. Keep breathing. Belly stays strong. As we start to get tired, all of a sudden our body starts to be in plank position or we stop exaggerating the bend in the knees. So notice how much my knees are bending. Exhale and inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, one more set each way, but then I want you to go back two more times to your tighter side. So you won't do a total 2-to-1 ratio. So exhale, and inhale, come to center. Exhale, just get that little bit extra length. Inhale, come to center. Knees go to the floor. Sit back onto your heels, Bhaktasana or Balasana, devotional or child's pose. Wiggle your hips back into your seat and breathe. Inhale, roll up. All right, take a seat. And you can turn forward, which is just fine. Bottoms of the feet come together, Baddha Konasana. And just taking hold on the underside of the ball of the foot. Let's peel the feet open rather than wrench on the toes. That rotation of the feet turning open, kind of like a book, is actually rotating the femur head in the hip joint. So inhale, lots of space, feel your spine extend. Exhale, fold forward. Shoulders slide down the back, gently fold towards the floor. Now mindfully breathe and offer yourself a moment here to let go of something that you may need to let go of. What is it that's been lingering in your life lately? That you've been storing in your kidneys, in your lower back, and just dragging with day after day? Allow your body to be symbolic of that release.
Inhale, rise up, and knees come together. Turn to the length of the mat. This is called Duranbo. Legs extend forward. Let's just come into forward bend to start. Keeping your hips connected, move from the hip as you fold forward, exhale. Now, rather than letting the sit bones flick up behind you, I want you to keep length as you lower. So the low back is really pulling apart. Now, if you need to, grab a strap. That way the feet are able to latch on with the hands. It's basically a little arm extender. If you have longer arms like I do, you can stick a block in front of the feet. And then move your heart forward, keeping your belly hollowing as you draw yourself down. Now I'm going to encourage you to flex into the feet as well, so we can get that much needed calf release. Remember, tightness travels. So if I skip my whole lower leg, just so I can feel hamstring or low back pull, I'm avoiding maybe what is the real culprit of the tightness, which could definitely be the lower leg and the foot. So inhale, extend over your thighs. Exhale, lower. You can leave your block behind. Inhale, roll up head as the last thing to lift so there's no tension. All right, let's move into that Duranbo. Move my block off to the side. There's lots of different variations. Work in a position in a place that's comfortable for you, but that encourages a challenge. Sometimes going beyond what our body is capable of, even though we've been taught push through the pain, keep going, don't stop, can have a negative effect on our bodies. So always be conscious of that edge line or that 80% line, and somewhere that sometimes that's the best place to dance is within that 80% realm. Sometimes 100% is just too much for our body to be able to handle, and we end up having a longer recovery time. All right, bend up your right knee. So right knee's gonna bend. You have a couple different handholds. Traditionally in Duranbo, you're holding the big toes with the first two fingers. For me, that sometimes bothers my toe joints and my fingers, believe it or not. So I prefer an inner foot hold. So I'm actually curling to the inside arch of the foot on both of the feet at the ball of the foot. Some people find that it works really well to hold on to the outer edges of the feet. Try not to get caught up on traditional technicality. It's just not necessary. We're still gonna be able to get the movement and still get the release we need to in the lower back. All right, so I'm gonna hold on to the ball of my left foot. Same thing with my right foot. Variation one, I'm gonna move my torso towards the thigh as I bring my foot back. So I'm just trying to flex the foot that's bent and press through what would be your left foot. That pressure like a gas pedal is really important because that's what's gonna start to initiate the release in the lower back. I'm gonna turn forward for a second so you can kind of see my body from this angle. So I'm reaching forward, elbows bending as my head gently comes down. This may be enough for you, and if that is, absolutely stay right here. If you're able to, lift the foot up off the floor. Remember, still a gas pedal. Finally, bring the foot up to the ear and press into the ball of the foot. So it's almost like talking on a telephone. Inhale through the nose. Exhale, stay there. I'm gonna turn back to the side again. Inhale through the nose, you're doing great. Exhale, breathe. Inhale, and exhale. Relax the top shoulder. You're rocking slightly to the left, and that's okay. Inhale, and exhale. One more breath. Inhale, lift the foot a little bit higher. And exhale, set the foot down, forward fold. Roll yourself up, hands behind the back, roll your shoulders in, and just a little lift in the heart, and nice extension out of the lower back. And then exhale, release. Here we come forward again. Grab for the feet, phase one, just keep the heel on the mat. Press into your gas pedal as you lower your torso. Phase two, I'm gonna try to lift my foot. Phase three, I'm gonna really lift my foot towards the ear. Five, phase forward again. A little bit of core strength, definitely. Pressing into the foot, so I feel length now on my right side. And as I lift the foot, I'm constantly and continually coming forward. Relax the folds of the elbow, so there's that drop in the shoulder. Inhale, and exhale. Focus on pressing into the front foot. You could absolutely use a strap if you needed to, if you just can't grab hold of that foot. Inhale, and exhale. You're doing great.
And exhale, lower the foot down. Rest forward, two breaths. Inhale, roll yourself up. Hands come behind the hips. This time, let's move into reverse table. Phase one, just keep your hips down. Roll the chest open and lift the heart and lift the lower back. Phase two, press into your feet, lifting the hips off the mat. Try not to let the knees fall open. Roll the shoulders back, drop the head. Three breaths. Exhale, lower the hips down. Come forward, seated child, two breaths. Inhale, roll up, you'll need a block. Gently bring yourself all the way onto the mat. As you bring yourself onto the mat, take your block. Probably the mid or lower level is definitely sufficient. Slide the block under the sacrum. Now, how do you know you're on your sacrum? It's the flat plate in your lower back area, probably by your pants. What's above that line is all of your more vertebrae or your lumbar vertebrae. So make sure you're not actually on the vertebrae themselves. This nice pressure should feel really good on your lower back. You can stay here, and if you feel you need to, hold the block securely with your hands or arms at your sides. Legs kick up. Now the top ridge, I'm gonna adjust my block here, the top ridge of the block closest to your back is gonna line up with the top ridge of the sacrum. So we're pulling S1 away from L5. Now if you need to hold the block, your block may tip a little bit and that's fine. Let your legs come in as your lower back releases. You can flex the feet to get a little bit more length. Let's just take five breaths. Inhale. Let gravity now do its job. Exhale, breathe, feel density in your belly and release in your upper back as well. Exhale, slowly release one foot at a time to the floor. Pause here, arms come overhead. Nice little stretch. Arms release down to your sides. Pick your hips up to release the block as you lower down. Gently drop the knees open into Supta Baddha Konasana. Arms drop to your sides, palms face up. Close the eyes, allowing the natural curve of the spine to come back into play. And completely release your body into the floor. Inhale deeply. And exhale completely. Start to feel the heaviness of your legs. Just start to exaggerate the pull of the spine just a little bit more. Shavasana is one of the most important poses in yoga. It's your recovery time for your body to really take in the benefits of your practice. So remain here for another 3 to 5 minutes or as long as you like. And when you're ready, bringing the knees together, roll to your side, use your top hand for help. Head follows as you press yourself up. I want to thank you so much for joining me tonight. This morning, I should say, unless you're watching me this evening. For more information, visit my blog and my website at hopesavara.com. You can send me an email at info@hopesavara.com. And definitely subscribe to my newsletter where you'll get all of my updates to all of my blog posts, any specials I'm running on my teacher trainings or workshops that I'll be hosting in your area. And if you have a special request, I'd love to hear from you. Just send me an email or feel free to submit a comment to this video. From my heart to yours, from my soul to yours, have an absolutely fabulous day. Namaste.